Hi everyone, my name's Sani and welcome to my maths adventure. In this video, I'll be giving you a review of Argand diagrams, the second chapter of the A-level Further Maths Core PO 1 book. Argand diagrams is the second chapter of the Pearson Edexcel Core PO 1 Further Maths book. It was interesting to see how complex numbers are applied to the XY plane and also the applications that you could achieve by seeing imaginary numbers plotted. The Argand diagram takes your understanding of complex numbers from the first chapter and applies it geometrically. In my first video in this series on A-level Further Mathematics, I said that Z equals A plus BI. In this chapter, we'll change it up a little bit by saying that z equals x plus yi instead, as we are now working in the complex plane. There's no difference, just a change of terminology. Now, there are five main sections in this chapter. The first three sections I really enjoyed. However, when I got to loci sections, then that's when things got really challenging. Now, there are many ways that loci can be represented on an Argand diagram. I can see why imaginary numbers can be so important in perhaps mechanical engineering, because some of these diagrams looks like they can be applied to the real world. Now, the key skills that you will need to know beforehand are coordinate geometry in the XY plane, to include finding the gradient, equation, length and midpoint of a line, the equations of lines which are parallel or perpendicular to a given line, the equation of a circle, finding the center given a point and radius, knowledge of radians, understand and use the modulus function, understand and use the trigonometric addition formulae, be able to interpret and sketch inequalities, and strong graph sketching skills. From my study experience, I think that this chapter will require you to have strong coordinate geometry skills from the first year of your A-level mathematics. Coordinate geometry is ubiquitous across all the exam boards in the UK. It's in the first year of your A-level mathematics study and one whole chapter in your textbook is dedicated to it. Nothing can be skimmed over because all the skills you learn in that chapter are essential, as you will need to learn them to solve problems in the Argand diagram. Don't gloss over the section on circles either in the coordinate geometry section. You'll need those circle skills to be able to do the loci exercises in this section. Now, there are key skills that you would need to know beforehand that aren't taught until the second year of your A-level mathematics course. These subjects are radians, the modulus function, and the trigonometric addition formulae. If you're studying the first year of your A-level mathematics course alongside the first year of your Further Maths course, then it will be challenging, as those skills won't be taught until the second year of your normal A-level maths course. My advice is to do some pre-study before you start this chapter. It's essential that you understand the modulus function and radians, as they are important elements of the modulus argument of a complex number. The trig addition identity also plays an important part in being able to manipulate equations in complex form. Looking at the specification, the topics that will be covered in this chapter are use and interpret Argand diagrams, understand and use Cartesian and modulus argument forms of a complex number, convert between Cartesian form and the modulus form of a complex number, multiply and divide complex numbers in modulus argument form, and construct and interpret simple loci in the Argand diagram. As I mentioned before, when you get to the loci section, it can get really challenging. You need a strong imagination to conceptualize the mathematical geometric diagrams. That's why good graph sketching skills is so important in this chapter. The ability to represent geometric interpretations of equations is sometimes a neglected skill in mathematics, because as math students, we don't get an opportunity to practice it much. Working in the complex plane will sometimes require you to draw a circle with a certain center and radius. You may have to sketch lines that may meet the circle either at the center, at a certain point, or at a tangent. Then as a further challenge, you may have to sketch angles measured in radians within that diagram as well. In summary, the Argand diagram chapter will extend your learning about complex numbers and will apply it to the XY plane. It's a demanding chapter that will bring together the core coordinate geometry and trigonometry skills from your first year A-level maths and key parts of the second year of your A-level maths syllabus as well. Now, there is an excellent video by Mrs. O'Gram's Maths where she gives a brief introduction to the elements that you'll be studying in this chapter on Argand diagrams. The video is a great way to get a flavour of what you'll be studying in this section and the skills that you will need. I'll link the video in the description above. The next chapter I'll be reviewing is series. Definitely a shorter chapter compared to the last two and will perhaps give you a short breather after these two challenging chapters on complex numbers and Argand diagrams. Hopefully you can join me in the next video on this A-level Further Mathematics review series.